Good morning, children. Today I am taking this grammar class. In common, that is for 8th, 9th and 10th. Because grammar is all the same for 8th, 9th and 10th. Eighth standard students now who have come to 9th standard and 9th standard students who have come to 10th standard, already this portion I have completed last year. But the newcomers coming from 7th standard to 8th standard, for them this is new. So in all for 9th standard and 10th standard it will be a good revision, and for 8th standard you will be the learners. Next year it will be the revision for you all. So pay attention here. Now I am dealing with homonyms. So what are homonyms? Let us see. Vocabulary and grammar, homophones. That is homophones. Homophones are words which sound similar, though either their meanings or their grammatical functions are completely different. That is, they are two different words. Now activities will start. Means, for example, I will give you all, I will write here, see the spelling here, M-I-N-U-T-E, minute. M-I-N-U-T-E, minute. So the pronunciation of the word is different here. Spelling is the same. Pronunciation is different. Minute means 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. Minute means very small. Similarly, second, and second. Second means first, second, like this. And second means 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. This is seconds. Pronunciation is the same, but the meanings are different. Pronunciation is different. These are homonyms. Now activities will start. I think you have understood what are homonyms. Homophones. Quite clear it must be to your minds. Again, you can hear my explanation on your mobiles, so you will come to know. Now, in activities, I will rub this. Number one, I will take here, number one, which of the two words given in brackets, is correct? Question mark. Underline the correct word. Underline the correct word. Now, what has happened in the activities, two words are given with little bit different spelling. Pronunciation is all the same here, but in the sentence we have to fill in the blanks with the correct word. The correct word has to be used in the blank space given here. Understand? I think you have understand. Now, the examples will start. I will rub this and I will start giving the examples on the board. Number one here, we must that is the gap here, that is a blank dash, practice. Practice. What we preach, whatever we preach, we must bring it into practice. Now, either of these two, which practice we must use? This practice is noun, this practice is verb. Actually, we have to, must has come means we have to use practice. So this one we have to use. I will mark it here. Now the second one. That is a dash. Naughty, N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty problem. Now, this is a naughty problem. This is a naughty problem. Which naughty we have to use? Naughty means difficult. Naughty means intricate. Unless you go by the dictionary, you will not understand. So while taking down these words, see the, which word you have to use, what the, what will be the meaning of the word if you use both naughty here, what meaning it will give. So actually this naughty means intricate problem. Third one I will give. India wants dash PEACE peace in the world. Now what India needs? One piece means tundu tundu galu, pieces, and another piece means calm, shanti. So this is needed, this piece is needed. So these are all homonyms, homophones. The fourth one I will give here, let us. Dash, PROCEED, let us proceed, oblique, PRECEDE, proceed with our
work.
Now the meaning of proceed is different, proceed is different. So we have to proceed means let us start our work. So this proceed is applicable. Excuse me, children, I will rub this and again I will start. The fifth one is, I will start from here. My eyes are dash, that is sore and S-O-R-E sore. You may be meaning sore eyes, your eyes becomes red and it starts soaring. So which sore we have to use? That is sore eyes, what we call, your eyes will become red. So that sore it is. Number six, his funeral rites oblique R-I-T-E-S rites were performed yesterday. Now which rites we have to use is, that is funeral rites means after death one function is there. These functions are called funeral rites. So that is these rites we have to use. Number seven, she leaves. She leads a quiet life. Quiet means shant, peaceful. So this quiet is applicable, not quite. Quite means exactly. Here, quiet means shant, peaceful life. Number eight, Ashoka's reign R-E-I-G-N reign was full of P-I-E-C-E peace, P-E-A-C-E peace. Now one you may be knowing, the second one you can was full of, here dash is there, full of dash, P-I-E-C-E peace and P-E-A-C-E peace. So here reign means rule. Ashoka's rule means R-E-I-G and reign, not R-A-I and reign. But P-I-E-C-E, peace, you may know this, P-E-A-C-E, peace. So, these are eight, which I have given on the board. Next, I will give you here. Ninth one. He will go dash. STRAIGHT straight oblique STRAIT. He will go straight means straight. Then which straight you have to use? This straight we have to use. Tenth one. She is dash VAIN vain VEIN vain of her beauty. Vain means she doesn't know about her own beauty, so we have to use VAIN vain. 11th one, why don't you? Why don't you get milk from a dash DARY oblique DADIARY? This is dairy, this is dairy. Dairy means where you get milk. So it is this dairy. Twelfth one, what dash CARER career CARRIER career. Do you want to follow? Career means future life. So we have to use this career and not this career. 12 I have given on the board. Still I will give. Thirteen, he is going to dash CANVAS canvas VASS and CANVAS canvas. For the Janata candidate, Janata candidate. Now, we have to see which canvas will come. That is, canvas means advertising on behalf of or making him familiar in the public or telling about him in the public or canvassing the party. That is canvas. 14. All foreign letters are opened by the dash, that is censor. And censor. So let us see who opens foreign letters. It is a rule that when we receive letters from foreign countries, they are chucked, they are censored. So which censor we have to use is censor. And the 15th one here, the last one I am giving here. The lion is the beast of dash prey, prey. And prey. Now which prey we have to use? This prey means praying God. This prey means hunting. So what is the behavior of the lion? Is it praise? Prey, prey. This is what I have given you all here. So before starting the next one, we'll stop a bit here because this is the outline timing is only for 30 minutes. And after this, again we'll start the next, that is, point out the difference in meaning between following pairs of words, using them in meaningful sentences. These words are given, we have to use them in meaningful sentences of your own. Thank you.